Gwinn at the Beach.
Thank you for making us the fastest growing syndicated show
at Gwinn at the Beach.
Nominated as Syndicated Show of the Year by the Carolina Beach Music Academy.
So, from all of us here, we'd like to say thank you. And keep listening to Pat Gwinn at the Beach.
Coast to coast and around the world. Hi there, it's Pat Gwinn with the band Punch. Don't worry about me. I'm Pat Gwinn at the Beach.
Hey, my friend, how you been? What are you going through? What is this trouble that's troubling you?
He tried to turn the thing around and asked me how I've been. Told me when daddy passed away, go take some time off, but I got no time to waste. Don't you have a dream too? Some goals you got to make. You may feel small sometimes, it don't mean you can't be great. I saw my life come crashing down.
This is Wayne Free of the Embers, and you're listening to Pat Gwinn at the Beach.
Through The superstar writing team of Holland, Dozier, and Holland do it again. In the spring of 1965, for the Four Tops and for the Motown label, Levi Stubbs found himself on top of the charts once again. It became number one twice, but not in consecutive weeks. First in June, and then again in July of that year. Levi Stubbs talks about the advent of doing it over and over, but this time it was a one-take wonder. Here's Levi Stubbs of the Four Tops.
Well, now, I Can't Help Myself is another tune that I personally, after we had recorded it, I didn't particularly think that I had done a good enough job on it. Then Brian walked in, I guess, and he was listening. He says, well, this is it, man. We don't have to go no further with this. I said, well, I'd like to do it again. But as it turned out, there was no tomorrow. As it was, it turned out to be one of our greatest all-time hits.
Rolling Stone magazine ranked it 415 of their all-time 500 greatest songs. Levi Stubbs, the Four Tops, Can't Help Myself.
One of my greatest joys of talking with the artist is to go beyond the song, go beyond the feeling and the passion and the emotion, and find out exactly where their influences began. Jim Stuttlemeyer of The Entertainers.
Oh, man, if I could tell you, Pat, when I was about 7 years old or so, my mother and my dad both worked, so they hired this lady to take care of us. And my mother would pick her up in the morning, bring her over to our house, and Ernestine would keep us all day, me and my sisters. She would have an armload of newspapers sometimes, and my mother would, you know, just thought she was bringing papers in to read during the day or whatever. But what the truth was, she had a bunch of records, but she didn't have a record player. So when I was about 7 or 8, I started getting exposed to groups and you know, like Four Tops, Temptations, Al Green, Willie Mitchell. I mean, just all kinds of old R&B and soul, a lot of Stax and Bolt, Wilson Pickett, Eddie Floyd, all that good stuff that, you know, it sent me in my days of rebelling, it sent me in a different direction than a lot of my friends who rebelled and listened to rock music. I was way more into the R&B and soul end of it.
Just can't find you. There's a very simple solution. You don't have to be a PhD. And don't look for a revolution. It's as easy as ABC. You need some music, not just any kind of music. Beats music. Baby, that's
The best beach and oldies on your radio. Hi there, it's Pat Gwinn. Still to come, the very latest from Gary Louder and Smoking Hot. H.A. Thompson shares memories of the old radio days in Charlotte, North Carolina. And did you ever wonder where the group Earth, Wind & Fire, the inspiration for the band name, ever came from? The story is told by the legend Maurice White. It's all coming up as Pat Gwinn of the Beach continues.
Oh, baby, come on. Come on. Pat Gwinn at the beach is on. Come on.
Pop open another. We'll wait for you.
Pop a top and turn the radio on. Come on. Because it's playing all your favorite songs.
Pat Gwinn at the beach continues in a moment.
Pat Gwinn at the beach is on.